मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टॉपिक फॉर टुडेज लेक्चर इज जुडिशियल कंट्रोल ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव एक्शंस। इन टुडेज एरा द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन प्लेज अ इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन एवरी इंडिविजुअल्स लाइफ। वी हैव अकॉर्डिंगली सीन द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव लॉ रिमार्कली एक्सपैंडिंग टू मीट द चेंजिंग डिमांड्स ऑफ द न्यू पॉलिटिकल, इकोनॉमिक एंड सोशल कंडीशंस। गोइंग बाय द वर्ड्स ऑफ जस्टिस क्वाद्री, द एसेंशियल डिफरेंस between a government of despots and a government of democratically elected persons is that in the former case there are no limitations on the powers or their exercise, whereas in the latter case the powers are defined and their exercise is regulated by the law. The necessity of the judicial review of administrative actions can be inferred in a democracy like India, which is governed by the rule of law. The principle be thou so high the law above you is rightly implied. Judicial review is an essential component of the rule of law. Administrative law was recognized as a separate branch of a legal discipline in the mid-20th century in India. Until well into the 19th century, the responsibilities of the state were few and limited, consisting of the maintenance of the public order, the conduct of the foreign affairs, and the disposition of the armed forces. Nowadays, it's far different. In the interest of protecting the public and maintaining the law and order, the state intervenes into the lives of its citizens to a very considerable degree. The actions which are carried out under the administrative law are called the administrative actions. An administrative action is a legal action which is concerned with the conduct of a public administrative body. This kind of action can compel an authority to take a certain action. It does not decide a right, though it might affect a right. The principles of natural justice cannot be ignored while exercising the administrative powers. Then comes judicial review. Judicial review has been recognized as a necessary and a basic requirement for the construction of an advanced civilization to safeguard the liberty and the rights of the citizen. The power of the judicial review in the India is significantly vested upon the High Courts and the Supreme Courts of India. Judicial review is the court's power to review the actions of other branches of government, especially the court's power to deem invalid actions exercised by the legislative and the executive as unconstitutional. Judicial review in India deals with judicial review of legislative actions, judicial review of administrative actions, and judicial review of judicial actions. And the grounds of judicial review is the doctrine ultra vires is the basic structure of the administrative law. It is considered as the foundation of judicial review to control the actions of the administration. Ultra vires refers to the actions which is made in excessive manners or the outside the ambit of the acting party. Generally, the grounds for judicial review in India are as follows. Number one, jurisdictional error, irrationality, procedural improprieties, proportionality, and legislative expectations. The above grounds of judicial review were given by the Lord Diplock of England in the case of Council of Civil Service Union versus the Minister of Civil Service. Jurisdictional error. Now, the jurisdiction means the term jurisdiction means the power to decide. There might be a lack of jurisdiction, excessive jurisdiction, or abuse of jurisdiction. The court may reject administrative actions on the ground of ultra vires in all these situations. The power of judicial review may be exercised on the following grounds. Number one, that the law under which the administrative authority is constituted and exercising jurisdiction is itself unconstitutional. Number two, that the authority is not properly constituted as the law requires. And third, that the authority has mistakenly decided a jurisdictional fact and henceforth assumed jurisdiction which did not belong it to first. I hope it must be clear to you. Thank you.